The speed of light is one controversial element that is essential to several laws of physics. On one hand, we know it is a limit we must exceed to travel effectively across the vast distances of the universe. At the same time, scientists know that going faster than light could cause us to break some of the oldest fundamental laws of physics, attracting dangerous consequences that we may or may not be able to handle. Join us in this exciting video as we explain how going faster than light leads to new paradoxes. It is no secret that the cosmos is infinitely vast, such that almost every two points in our galaxy are separated by millions and billions of miles. These distances are so unfathomable that even the earliest radio signals sent by scientists are believed to have covered less than 1 millionth of the entire distance of our cosmos, even though they are traveling at the speed of light. On paper, this constant is regarded as an impossibility, at least for human entities. Its true value is around 300,000 kilometers per second. Meanwhile, the fastest any man-made object has ever traveled is 163 kilometers per second. The vast difference between these two figures and the recognition of how difficult it is for humans to travel at the speed of light is perhaps the reason why it is often called the cosmic speed limit. But could we possibly exceed this limit someday? Is there a way for humans to travel faster than light? This is one question that has been asked one too many times by astronomers and ordinary humans out of fascination and sheer curiosity to explore the universe and its wonderful offering. But so far, we are restricted by the cosmic speed limit. As you know, the concept of the cosmic speed limit was first put forward by Albert Einstein many decades ago. And expectedly, humans were quick to refute the idea, perhaps because it was something we couldn't immediately wrap our heads around. Even after several years of exploring it, we are still unable to develop a system that can possibly travel faster than light. But scientists have continued to explore the idea in hopes that they could one day crack the code. From our previous works, we know for a fact that Einstein's speed limit only applies to space travel. However, we know well enough that space is constantly expanding in different directions. And some experts think they might be receding from us even faster than the speed of light. To successfully travel to these places, we must find a way to manipulate space and time, using both elements to develop and facilitate a device that can travel faster than light. Of course, curiosity has led some scientists to attempt this Herculean task. But so far, the theoretical warp drive is the closest we've come to building a system that can transcend the vastness of space faster than the famous speed limit. First demonstrated in the movie Star Trek, the warp drive, or alcuibierre drive, is a system that proves there is a provision within Einstein's relativistic field equations that allows us to travel faster than light, at least theoretically. Scientists behind this intuitive transportation system believe that by expanding space behind itself and contracting it ahead, a bubble of space could possibly swim through the stars and galaxies in space at crazy speeds that exceed the speed of light. While this is a method that could potentially work, there are a few challenges that must be sorted out first. One of them is the challenge of matter and energy. To build a real-life warp drive system, scientists need to be able to generate and manipulate exotic matter and energy at a massive rate that is currently deemed impossible. However, optimists argue that there could be a way around it. But even if that is sorted, we would still have to find a way to integrate quantum effects into the alcuibierre drive. Also, Finazzi proved back in 2009 that a warp drive bubble is susceptible to an exponential increase in Hawking radiation on the inside, which is hazardous to the crew. We mustn't also forget that our knowledge of quantum gravity is still limited, meaning the concept of alcuibierre drive is built entirely on our understanding of general relativity. Wormholes are another hypothetical medium by which we could achieve faster travel than light. However, they have been often described as unstable because of the quantum effects, which are ignored by general relativity. As a matter of fact, until we solve the mystery of quantum gravity, we might never be able to prove the existence of wormholes or even the alcuibierre drive. Adding to this dilemma, there are several other ideas out there that scientists believe could one day power our dream of traveling deep into the universe. They include tachyons, Krasnik optubes, quantum tunneling, and entanglement. Expectedly, each idea comes with its own principles that we sometimes are not able to follow. For instance, the energy and exotic matter requirements of the warp drive are one principle or rule that we've struggled with. Scientists have tried to reduce these requirements to the barest minimum, but so far, we haven't had much luck. But it doesn't necessarily mean the idea is entirely dead. One way to explain the complexity of this topic is by using the Minkowski diagram. To further build our knowledge around it, let's consider the existence of a distant star like Vega in comparison to Earth. If you put both elements in the space-time diagram, you'd notice that Earth is a bit less mobile and thus has a parallel world line. Consequently, we don't exactly feel any movement. Hence, the world line indirectly translates to no travel through space. But if somehow we achieve instantaneous travel, we would be able to go from Earth to Vega with no time passing at all. But there are some other problems that must be conquered. For instance, if a casualty violation should happen, it could lead the crew to potentially break the universe. To understand how this works, let's assume a message is sent from Earth all the way to Vega. But rather than reaching its final destination, let's say it's intercepted by a crew aboard an STL ship. Having received the message, they are of course expected to reply. And let's say they decide to do so using the built-in faster-than-light transmitter on their ship. But due to the complexities of the system, we know the message will travel backwards through time. That means the control center on Earth will receive the message even before it is sent from the spaceship. In other words, this conundrum can be described as killing someone, perhaps your grandparents, before they were actually born. Thinking about this whole scenario again, let's assume FTL messages are not just faster than light, but instantaneous. This would lead to even more complications and basically confirm that the casualty violation is not just an academic inconsistency. As a matter of fact, it's a phenomenon that triggers a number of time travel paradoxes, which scientists don't exactly enjoy solving because of the level of complexities involved with it. Stephen Hawking did attempt to solve it back in the day, and even though he didn't exactly succeed, his explanation of the paradox is the best one yet. In addition, Stephen Hawking's radiation theory could also help us solve the enormous radiation problems inside the alcuibierre drive. This could be really important in helping us design a faster-than-light traveling medium, especially considering that Hawking radiation is a quantum effect, a record that even our unified theory of quantum mechanics and gravity has failed to provide. So regardless of the fact that we are still behind in our knowledge of how quantum effects and gravity interact, Hawking's chronology protection conjecture possibilities suggest that the answer we seek is embedded in the missing knowledge itself. And perhaps one day, we will uncover a unified and concluding theory that conveniently covers and explains all these gray areas. More importantly, they'd be hoping that this long-awaited theory will also help to explain why time travel paradoxes exist, or why they shouldn't even happen in the first place.